young talent in music and art. TheSkyKid.com.
Dad, these are people's names.
That's right. And they'll look like people too. But they're not.
TheSkyKid.com coming of age movie review. Frailty, 2001, reviewed by Georgie Krostov.
Destroying demons is a good thing.
Nothing that crazy
Killing
could be real.
Is bad.
If the opening credits of a film serve the role of a teaser, then Frailty's credits perfectly fit that bill. A suspenseful selection of music, typical of thriller openings, and gritty visuals serve as a perfect example of how to grab one's attention from the very beginning. True, they do not hint of the coming-of-age thematic of the story per se, as one discovers early on in the film. It's been a while since I have watched a film with such an original and engaging narrative as that of Frailty. Its story is twisted and disturbing, involving a shattered childhood and lost innocence. It's fully capable of gripping the viewers' minds while challenging their perception of good and evil.
You doubt me?
They were raised to obey their father.
Go do some homework.
To love him. To trust him.
Night, boys. Sleep tight.
Don't let those bed bugs bite.
Until...
Wake up. I've got something to tell you.
Hey, what's wrong?
There are demons among us. I can see the demons while other people can.
I'm scared, Dad.
Nothing that crazy could be real.
The angel told me that God would be sending weapons.
Maybe you just dreamed it. Maybe you're not right in the head.
God will be sending a list of the first seven demons.
These are people's names.
And they'll look like people. They're not.
Dad made up this whole thing. Do you understand?
Well, if it has to be done, it has to be done.
Is that true?
Why would I make it up?
It's all a big lie.
I don't want to run away.
You are hiding something from me.
What is it you think I'm hiding?
When I lay my hands on them, I'll reveal them for what they truly are.
The director employs a retrospective narrative to address the film's dark subject matter, a serial killer and manipulation, using an adult protagonist, Fenton Meeks, Matthew McConaughey. Fenton recalls an evening during his childhood when he and his little brother Adam, Jeremy Sumpter, are awakened by their father, played by director Bill Paxton, who claims to have been visited by an angel who has bestowed their family with a mission to hunt demons, thereby assisting God in the final battle between good and evil. The boys are perplexed to hear about their dad's visions, yet both have a very different response to them. While Fenton doubts the sanity of his father, Adam is more than willing to help his dad, and help God get rid of the demons that roam the earth. Decisions are yet to be taken and acted upon, but one thing clear, life as they have known it is no more.
The angel told me that God would be sending weapons.
Maybe you just dreamed it. Maybe you're not right in the head.
God will be sending a list of the first seven demons.
These are people's names.
And they'll look like people. They're not.
When it comes to the acting performances, I must admit that what I saw exceeded my expectations. Bill Paxton as Dad Meeks delivers such a genuine persuasive performance that one feels almost ready to believe his story of God, angels and the demons that are to be destroyed. Such a notion is scary, but somehow the fact that the actors managed to achieve that level of manipulation allows the viewer to understand better how his ideas may have affected the innocent, young minds of his sons. Matt O'Leary, as young Fenton Meeks, turns in one of the best acting performances I have ever seen in cinema. Much of the coming-of-age nuances of the film come from his struggle to understand, make sense of and eventually fight the will of his father. This makes him the main driving force behind the story, told from his perspective as an adult recalling past days and events. O'Leary's stellar performance includes verbalizing feelings and emotions in dialogue. A memorable scene is one in which Fenton, after being presented by his dad with a list of demons to be destroyed, exclaims, "Dad, these are people's names." And he also is superb at expressing them through his gestures and facial expressions. In that same scene, observe his face as his dad goes on to explain his visions with, "That's right, and they will look like people too, but they are not." Yes, throughout the film, Matt O'Leary is always natural and sincere, which facilitates one's identification with his character or, at the very least, makes one really care for his fate. Jeremy Sumpter, a cinematic debut for the young actor, is equally convincing as Fenton's little brother Adam. And, while his role is more of a supporting one, his character projects a collage of children's psychological traits, innocence, curiosity and even cruelty at times, all in an impeccable manner. After watching his performance in Frailty, it comes as no surprise that Jeremy aced the role of Peter Pan in the infamous 2003 live-action film directed by P.J. Hogan. The film is atmospherically extremely dense. Its haunting musical score, beginning with the movie's opening sequence, persists throughout, bewitching the overall mood of the story. Combine that score with beautiful photography, somehow a portrayal of one's childhood days always manages to retain a degree of beauty and innocence, regardless of the context in which it's placed, an intelligent script and great direction, this film manages to invoke anxiety in its viewers. The viewer is always able to catch subtle nuances or symbolism that may have escaped one's attention initially. Admittedly, the film has a 90s feel to it, but, in my book, that's a good thing and doesn't lessen the viewer's enjoyment. A psychological thriller with strong coming-of-age motifs, Frailty is a true masterpiece that deserves to be seen. You can find a complete written review of the film at theskykid.com.
Young talent in music and art. Theskykid.com.